Welcome to Fireborn Family Lives. Join us on a wild journey into the world of Northern Inuits where breeding tales and doggy adventures come alive. If you are here for unfiltered, pause on truth about dogs and breeding, you're in the right spot. So let's dive in without any further delay and talk dogs on. Joined by Talvi, so you will hear her walking around and probably licking my face soon enough. I'm Dani, and along with my husband Chris, we've been lovingly owned by our Fireborn Northern Inuits for most of our adult lives. Our mission? To preserve, develop and perfect the incredible Northern Inuit dog. We want the whole world to hear about them. We are part of Northern Inuits International Unleashed Breeding Club, whose high standards and breeding strategy very much aligns with our own. And we are working with other amazing and dedicated breeders across the UK to achieve our aims. Today's topic is a high-level introduction to the Northern Inuit dog. Ever wondered about those incredible dogs you might have spotted on a walk in a park or at an event? Or maybe caught a glimpse of them in season one of the Game of Thrones? Yep, we are talking about Northern Inuit dogs. Northern Inuits are an absolutely fascinating breed with rich and complex characters. I think this is what makes them so addictive. They made their debut back in the 1980s in the UK and have since evolved into a breed with distinct traits, personality and quirks, although they are not yet recognised by any major national kennel club. These magnificent dogs are bred within individual clubs like Northern Inuit International Unleashed, predominantly in the UK. These dogs are epitome of loyalty, affection and love, but don't be fooled, they are also fiercely independent, stubborn and sometimes a bit too clever for their own good. They are endlessly curious, which means you'll often find yourself shouting no as they poke their noses where they shouldn't. Sometimes I swear our pups thinks their names are no or leave it. Now, Northern Inuits aren't for the faint of heart or novice owners. If you are considering welcoming one into your home, you'll need a good sense of humour, endless patience and willingness to put in some serious time and effort, and of course enjoy a good challenge. These dogs aren't going to sit just because you said so. They'll check, then double check, and then maybe, just maybe, they'll comply if they feel like it. They get bored with repetitive training and will simply walk away if they've decided it's too mundane or they're bored. Recall training? Let's just say that there better be something extraordinary in it for them or their selective hearing will kick in and they'll pretend they didn't hear you. They can have varying degrees of prey drive, but with some, recall can be trained when consistently started from a young age. Northern Inuits are super caring and incredibly bonded to their families. They can be a bit reserved with strangers and new situations, so early and ongoing socialization is crucial. We also believe that Northern Inuits need to be socialized throughout their lives and not just when they are puppies. They are generally non-aggressive, have no real guarding instincts, but boy, they love to howl. Some of them also bark like our Cora. You can have the most entertaining conversations with them because they always have to get the last word in. But that strong family bond comes with a dark side, separation anxiety. They can be quite the home remodelers when they're bored or left alone. Our house has been redesigned more than once by some of our more spirited pups. And don't even get me started on their landscaping skills. They're absolute pros at digging up the garden. So if you need a landscape gardener, we have a few for hire just here. These dogs are amazing companions, but can be a bit boisterous during playtime. If you have another dog, they better enjoy a good rough and tumble because Northern Inuits play hard. They tend to thrive in multi-dog household, but it's not impossible to keep one as a solo pet. Just be ready to invest even more time and energy. Oh, and they pick up on behaviours quickly from the other dogs, whether they are good or bad habits. In the end, if you are ready to put in the time and effort to raise a Northern Inuit puppy, you'll be rewarded tenfold. They'll become a loving, loyal, hilariously cheeky companion who'll make you laugh every day and be your best friend. Just a fair warning, these dogs are addictive. Once you enter the wild world of Northern Inuits, there's no going back. Many people find it impossible to stop at just one, and honestly, who would want to? So this is the part where we're going to give you an update from Fireborn Lives, our Fireborn blog. Every week, we aim to share a glimpse of our lives with Northern Inuit dogs, giving you an inside look at what it's truly like to live with these wonderful dogs. And this week, we have some incredibly exciting news. If you've been following us on social media, you might already know that our Siri is pregnant. We're over the moon, brimming with a mix of worry, excitement and anticipation as we prepare to ensure everything goes as smoothly as possible. Siri had a magical date with George at the end of May, marking the first step on her journey to becoming a mom. And mating time can be quite the emotional roller coaster for both moms and dads, especially since it was Siri's and George's first time. We had plans from A to Z in place, just in case, because let's face it, you never really know what to expect. But last week, we had the joy of confirming Siri's pregnancy with an ultrasound scan. We spotted multiple little puppies on the scan, though it's hard to say how many there are. Sometimes the ultrasound can't capture them all. We suspect it may be a smaller litter because they were all cozied up right next to her bladder, and we couldn't find any higher up. This is actually wonderful news because it means we'll have more time to spend with each precious puppy once they're born. Did I mention we are beyond excited but also a bit anxious, hoping that everything goes perfectly. Her due date is set for 24th of July, but there is always a chance that things might change as puppies can be absorbed during the pregnancy, so watch this space. As for Siri, our girl is definitely slowing down a bit these days. Bless her, she's not keen on long walks right now, but yes, she's got quite the appetite. We've started to gradually increase her food, but we're doing it carefully to make sure she doesn't gain too much weight too quickly. By the end of next week, she'll probably be eating more than 1.5 times her usual amount. Siri loves nothing more recently than a cozy snuggle, and she even purrs like a little cat in the mornings. It is so sweet. She's not normally known for her cuddly nature, so we are enjoying while we can. So stay tuned as we continue to share this incredible journey with you, and we can't wait to welcome Siri's puppies into the world and share every moment with you all. Our second point in the Fireborn Diary is ticks. Yes, those pesky little creatures have decided to make this summer their grand debut. We are right in the middle of the action at the moment. We recently took a lovely walk near Ampleforth, and oh boy, did we get more than we bargained for. We ended up with a full-on tick infestation. I don't think I've ever seen this many ticks in North Yorkshire during the summer months. We were plucking tens of those tiny horrors of our dogs. But of course, we couldn't get them all, and some of them hitched a ride back to our house. So our entire home had to be cleaned, washed and disinfected. Ticks are incredibly hard to kill, and we're still finding a few stubborn ones attached to our girls. We've been warned by friends that this summer might be especially bad because of the mild winter we had, which didn't do too much to curb the tick population. So here we are, spraying the house with apple cider vinegar solution twice a day and doing the same for our dogs. It's quite a task, but we're determined to keep them as safe as we can. If you are dealing with ticks, make sure you're using good quality organic apple cider vinegar with mother. It's essential for the best results. We are also adding it to their drinking water, which helps to change their skin scent to deter ticks. For Siri, we'll stop this next week because it can interfere with milk production in pregnant girls, and we certainly don't want that. I've added some product ideas for you in the episode description. We're also using a special spray containing colloidal silver and essential oils from lemongrass, cedarwood and neem. This spray has antibacterial properties and a strong scent that ticks absolutely despise. We've also started adding garlic to the food to keep those ticks at bay, but that's a whole other topic we'll delve into later in other episodes, so stay tuned for that. There's no guarantees that all of this will completely stop them, but we are hoping it will deter them enough for us not to worry too much about the Lyme disease. So here you have it. That's our tick tale for the week. We hope you found it helpful. Also, let me tell you about evil sprout Talvi deciding to channel her inner mole hunter. So imagine this. It's a sunny day and we're just enjoying the peace and quiet when suddenly we hear some commotion in the garden. Curious, we step outside and there she is, our beautiful Talvi, sitting there with her tail wagging like she's the happiest dog in the world. But of course, she's covered from head to toe in soil. From her ears to her paws, she's a walking mud monster. And you know that look, ears back, wide eyes, and that I swear it wasn't me the devil made me face. Yep, she was wearing that look like a pro. We couldn't help but laugh because obviously she wasn't fooling anyone. And right in front of us were two absolutely massive craters dug out in the garden. It was like she decided to redesign our yard in the span of a few minutes. Apparently, Talia has found two molehills and in her infinite wisdom decided they absolutely needed investigating. Maybe it just smelled too good to ignore. Whatever it was, she went full archaeologist on us and, of course, in her quest to unearth the secrets of the molehole, she managed to transform herself into the dirtiest dog of the day. And she really doesn't like baths. Oh dear. We love you, Talia. So that's all for this week. Thank you so much for your time and listening to this podcast. I am hoping you enjoyed it and it was informative. I really hope that you will join us for more adventures and misadventures. We would really appreciate if you can give us 5-star reviews. And if you have any comments or suggestions of what we can talk about next, please get in touch via private message. I have listed our social media accounts in the details of this podcast. And let's talk dogs on Prologue next time round. Thank you so much once again and see you soon.